welcome. Thank you for being here in person or for watching the live streaming tonight. Tonight, our senior high music students have quite a show for you. All have been working incredibly hard in preparation for this concert, and we hope you enjoy their performances. First, a few housekeeping things we'd like to begin with. We work on concert etiquette with our students and hope that you role model the same appropriate concert etiquette. Please remember, one, it's okay to take pictures during the concert. However, please make sure your phones are on silent, as any extra noises can cause a disruption during the performance. Two, please do not get up during the performance if at all possible. If you need to leave, please wait until the song is over. Three, although we do an amazing job playing our music, we are not a rock concert or an athletic event. Clapping is a great way to show how much you enjoyed our performance, while yelling and screaming our names or whistling is not acceptable for this type of performance. Thank you so much.
started with our senior high band members, the concert and symphonic bands. This group is composed of grades 9 through 12 band students, some who rehearse with all juniors and seniors, our concert band, others who rehearse with all freshmen and sophomores, our symphonic band. But they all come together for performances. They are performing the three pieces they will be taking to large group contests for three esteemed judges this Thursday at Lake Crystal Welcome Memorial High School. The first piece was The Vise Prevail by Richard Sauceda, which pushes us to play an unusual time signature like 5/4 or 7/8, while still projecting the melody among some sometimes lush, other times articulate rhythms. The last piece we'll be performing is Burn by Roland Barrett, which is truly 1 minute and 45 seconds of intense chord progressions, melodies with counter melodies, full group dynamics, and individual surprises.
Our next piece, An American Elegy by Frankie Kelly, premiered on April 23rd, 2000, at the Combine High School Band in conjunction with the University of Colorado Women's Symphony, under the guest direction of Frankie Kelly himself. This year is the 25th anniversary of the horrific school shooting at Combine. Mr. Kelly wrote in his program notes that he was moved and honored by this commission invitation and deeply inspired by the circumstances surrounding it. An American Elegy is, above all, an expression of hope. It was composed in memory of those who lost their lives at Combine High School on April 20, 1999. In honor of survivors, it is offered as a tribute to the great strength and courage in the face of a terrible tragedy. He hopes the work can also serve as a one reminder of how fragile and precious life is, how intimately connected we all are as human beings. This is An American Elegy. Thank you.
musician. We're about ready. I'm going to go ahead and introduce them, and then I think we'll be ready to roll here. Welcome to the orchestra portion of our evening. The high school orchestra split into two performing groups, and both performed at large group contest in Mankato this past February. I could not be more proud of how our Fairmont orchestras performed. Judges noticed that this group had a wonderful vibrato, solid intonation, and a great full sound. My favorite comment was from our clinician. He was working with these 9th and 10th graders, and he kept saying over and over again how special this group was. I've always known they were special, but it was great to hear it from someone else too. Tonight we will be performing the first movement of a work called Elementa, featuring a cello solo by Liz Hart, and then followed by a piece that we played at contest called Dance of Iscariot.
Thank you.
This group had a really solid performance on some tough pieces, and I was most impressed with their consistency. It sounds a little weird, but once we get used to how we sound in our rehearsal space, it's sometimes hard to take that to a new space for the performance and sound just as good as you remember in rehearsal. These guys adapted to the new space almost instantly, and they should be so proud of how they sounded. The judges praised them for their ability to listen to each other, which is a really difficult and sometimes rare skill in high school orchestras. First up tonight, you'll hear Game of Thrones with Maddie Pyman on percussion. This is a song the seniors picked. Then you'll hear Hungarian Dance, which was performed at contest.
Thank you.
program will feature Matthew Malo on violin. Matthew was the highest scoring senior at solo and ensemble contests a few weeks ago for his performance of the Akale Violin Concerto in A minor. This is a really complicated piece of music, and Matthew has spent a year practicing every last detail. He's poured so much focus and attention into learning this piece. I'm so excited.
Thank you. our concert choir became too large, and we needed to figure out a division for them. And so we have fellow boot camp with just my gals here. So it's very fun. They're going to sing three songs for you. Lakeside Lullabies by Jacob Navarro. It's a very end of the day at the lake story, so it's very fitting for a city that has five lakes in it. Their second piece is an original composition in a spiritual style. It's called Ain't Judge No Man by John Parker and Greg Gilpin. And then finally we'll close with She Used to Be Mine. Was featured in the In a Waitress the musical. This is an arrangement by Matt Koff, and we have four soloists in that line.
Thank you.
tonight. Our first is Landon Peterson. He's a senior this year. He'll be graduating in May. The solo that he took is called I Choose Love by Mark Miller. And Landon was one of our, we have two singers that tied in their score at solo ensemble contest with the highest score. So out of 40 points, Landon was awarded 38. So he's going to sing that song.
Is Alex Martin. She's going to be singing I Dreamed a Dream from the musical Les Mis, also one of our top scorers.
I dreamed a dream in time gone by, when hope was high and life worth living. I dreamed that love would never die. I prayed that God would be forgiving. When I was young and unafraid, and dreams were made and used and wasted, but still I dream he'd come to me, that we would live the years together. But there are dreams that cannot be, and there are storms we cannot weather. I had a dream my life would be so different from this hell I'm living, so different now from what it seemed. Now life has killed the dream I
adjust on the fly a little bit. We've never actually practiced this up here, so Tiffany, I'm going to have you go all the way to kind of to the edge. Yeah, because we're kind of a crooked, swoopy thing happening. I don't know. Okay. This song definitely needs a quick intro. Mostly the composer of this piece, or the arranger, is Kyle Peterson, and he is a Minneapolis-based composer. And this was commissioned in 2020 by the Wartburg Choir, shortly after a lot of unrest in the cities. He composed this. So one of the things in his notes that he really wants you to know is that he said, to me, spirituals are the most powerful type of music. Spirituals were birthed and rooted in the experience of chattel slavery in the United States and arose out of deeply meaningful human experiences that are relevant not only to the specific circumstances of slavery, but also to women and men struggling with issues of justice, freedom, and spiritual wholeness in all times and all places. Spoken word has often been used as the language of protest, and I include it intentionally as a way of giving voice to the choir members and listeners, where all can stand in solidarity against oppression and injustice. This is our 2024 Director's Honor Choir, and they will be singing for you. Soon we will be done.
With the hatred and done with war.
There they are. Okay. While they're walking on, I will do a little, just a, save time, right? Okay. Concert choir. This group prepared three of the most difficult pieces that were taken to large group choral contests this year. The first is called Thunder by Randall Johnson. It's a traditional Sioux chant arranged by Randall Johnson. And then he wants you to know this. There is a Sioux legend that the Unktehi, the giant horned snakes, tried to drown all the people by swelling up their bodies in all the rivers and streams. Joaquin Yantanka, the great thunder being, wanted the people to live and, along with other Joaquin Yan, fought the Unktehi for years. Finally, all of the Joaquin Yan flew to the sky and unleashed an enormous thunderbolt that burned all of the Unktehi. The people were saved, and the dried, charred bones of the Unktehi can be found in Makosika, the Badlands, and the Joaquin Yantanka lives in Pahasaba, the Black Hills, to this day. The second piece that they will sing is called Oh Love, and it's by Elaine Hagenberg. This is a deceptively difficult ballad-style piece. I know when we first picked it, we're like, ah, oh, we love this one, it's going to be so... And then we found out just how tricky her writing is. But it expresses the gratefulness of the singer to the person or being that has always been there for them, that brings them and encourages them with the hope to carry on. And finally, we close with a very less serious piece, What Shall We Do with a Drunken Sailor?, which you will see is a favorite of some of our singers. And again, we're like, oh yeah, that sounds fun. And it is hard. The rhythms were hard, but we got it. And we had to work on musical interpretation, you know, telling the story through our faces and our bodies. And well, we'll see how it goes. But they were amazing at contests, so I can't wait for you to hear them. Here is Fairmont High School Concert Choir.
Thank you.
And when Kate asked if I wanted her to play, I said, I do. I want the best, and that would be you.
So thank you so much. You guys have been amazing. Thank you for a great night, and have a safe drive home. Jazz band, and rip your floats. Never mind. Okay, but still, get out of here. Okay, good night, everybody.